Rotax on. In fact, they do not use Rotax, but this is one of our market leaders. This is clearly the number two, way ahead of anybody else. And they're an American-based company, and it's called American Legend. And you know what? That's a pretty good name for this company, I think.
This looks like a cup.
It does look like a cup, and their address is even Piper Lane. Can you imagine? But it's not a cup. Well, it is a cup, but it's a Legend cup. And one of the differences you can tell from the original is because I'm standing in a place where I couldn't stand on an old Piper cup. They didn't have a door that opened on this side. This one opens on both sides, so when it's float equipped, and they just won ASTM approval for a float equipped cup. So that's an exciting new development for this company. But when that's the case, now you can get out on both sides of the airplane. You can dock it easily. You can access the dock to do your tie downs and so forth. It's a big feature. But that's not the only one that comes with this. In a cub, when you flew it solo, you had to sit in the back seat. Well, it's kind of hard to reach the paddle from the back seat. And this airplane puts the fuel in the wings instead of up front where the old Piper Cup did. So that means the way that fuel is at the CG line, that means you can solo it from either seat, which is really a cool thing. Of course, most of the time you'd want to be in the front where you can see better, have access to all your instrumentation, and all your controls are in an easy reach. These fellas have done a really good job with this. And they've also added some electronic instrumentation to the panel that wasn't available in the old Piper Cubs, but it's got a lot of the same features, including a nice storage area. But one thing we saw on other airplanes, recoil seat belts, and they've got them front and rear, which is a nice quality. Just makes the airplane a lot more user-friendly. We're used to these things in cars. Why not on airplanes? No problem on the American Legend.
And you've also got a skylight in this as well.
You've got a skylight overhead, got lots of visibility, even got some handholds here on the space frame structure. And if you can see over my head, here's a really nice execution of the sight gauge. And I really like this kind of fuel gauge. As everybody in aviation knows, you really can't trust an on-panel gauge. You keep track of your time and how much fuel you have. Well, this is even better yet. While it sits in flight, of course, this is going to be angled the right way. It's a tail dragger, so it's sitting tail low right now. This is going to give you this on, and it's on each side. Your camera can't see it, but there's some switches and other controls up here in this wing root panel, which is very nicely executed. I mean, just look at the way this is all done. Everything about this airplane, all its interior finish, just a clean, sanitary job of making an airplane that is an icon in aviation.
Now, you're not going to find that on the Cub. What I'm seeing out here in front now.
Yeah, no, you certainly won't. Nothing like this. Well, it didn't even exist back in those days. They've got this beautiful, I mean, this is a popular choice these days, the 696 from Garmin. And boy, there's all the instrumentation you want. Now, what they've got it set on right here now is the GPS screen, but there's also some other instrumentation available. It's a computer, basically. You can have a lot of things on it if you want. But they use the analog gauges for those of us that kind of grew up with those and are comfortable with those. And for some people, an analog gauge is still a faster read. All you have to do is glance at a needle to know about where it's at on a screen, on a gauge, whereas on a screen, you actually got to read stuff. So there are people who find the argument of analog gauges to actually be superior. And maybe that's true in the modern age.
And what type of control systems do we use on this?
Well, here you've got joysticks, and we're tied down here because we've got a little wind going on, but you got joysticks front and rear in this airplane. Full dual controls, front and rear. Regular rudder pedals, front and rear for both occupants here. The rear occupant puts his feet right alongside here, not in the way of this pilot. But one difference that's kind of unique about this airplane compared to most of our other LSA is heel brakes. And if you can look down here where my hand is at, I'll put my hand behind it. It's a black thing, so you can't see it so well. Heel brakes on both sides, but not just in the front. They're also in the back. This gold fitting down here that I'm trying to reach, that's the heel brakes for the aft seat pilot, because you can solo this airplane from either seat, or you could do training in it, of course, as well.
It looks like a lot of storage back here, too, Dave.
Yeah, look at all this area back here. A lot of area back here. It holds 40 pounds, so you won't want to put heavy weights back there, but sleeping bags, things like that, a lot of bulky items. There's a lot of cubic volume back there, and that's important for such things.
Now, we also mentioned earlier that this has got a different engine on it. Why this engine?
Well, for one, they use the Continental engine. Now, it's an American-made engine. It's also the one the Piper Cub had in it, or that brand, not the same engine. And for a lot of people, that's an important quality. They kind of like to have something that they're familiar with.
Now, have you flown this airplane yet?
I have gotten to fly this airplane. It was a really enjoyable experience, just kind of like the old Cub, but better. So what's not to love about that? And I've got that information on my website. And if you want more from them, you just go to legend.com. legend.aero, A-E-R-O, that web address. So legend.aero will get you all kinds of information. They've got very nice information prepared by their PR fellow, easily read. And on my website, you can read the pilot report I've got on this at bydanjohnson.com or bydanjohnson.com.